Hey kids, today we are making another one of Granny's dishes. Actually, we're making two. That's why you see two pots. We are making pork with white stem cabbage. I bought some of that at the farmer's market. Four bunches for $2. And Scott came home with a squash from his friend. So the other one is going to be pork and squash. Now, why are we doing it on the same day together? Well, that's because they both have the exact same recipe. It's just interchangeable with the vegetable. And you want to start out in each one with about a tablespoon of oil and garlic to your taste. And you don't want, you can just crush them. You don't have to mince them. You don't want to get it so that you're going to eat a piece of garlic. So if you leave it nice and big, you'll be able to figure it out. Same with the ginger that we're going to add later. Now, I know that the sizzle is going to try to overtake me. So I'm going to sign off to just get your pork cooked. And when that's done, we'll be back. Okay, so now the pork has been cooked, and you want to go ahead, like the beef stew, you want to cover it with water and a little bit over. This is going to be like comfort food. This is going to end up sort of like more like a soup. Hang on, Granny's coming. She's going to help us with the shoyu and the sugar. So, because she uses her own measurements. Okay, so what I did was I took a piece of ginger, and it's about the size of your thumb. Just go ahead and, you know, peel the outside, and I kind of crushed it. Crush it, okay? So you release some of its juices. Keep it nice and big because you don't want somebody taking that and biting into it. So one for each. Okay, hang on a second. I'm going to turn you off while we get the sugar and the shoyu ready. Okay, here goes Granny.
Okay.
We're going to kind of guesstimate, people.
Yes.
Are you going by color again? Ooh, that's about a half a cup, right?
Yep.
Okay, half a cup of shoyu. All right. We're going by color, right? You want to get it to...
Yes, nice.
Like a nice brown. Let me get you up a little taller, people. And she just used about... She used a 1/3 cup of sugar.
Right.
And she left in about 1/3 of that. So use
about 1/4.
You think that? Okay, wait, stop. Don't use that. Hang on a second. Okay. Hang on, people. We're going to try something here. That's about what she's going to put into the container right here. Has the tablespoon measurements. You're right. Three tablespoons. Three tablespoons of sugar to about, oh, no. 1.5.
We have to taste it.
Oh, okay. So she has to stir it, and she has to taste it. Oh. Let me get you a spoon then.
Yes.
Or are you going to put your gloves inside
there?
Okay. Okay, she's stirring it. She likes to bring it up to a boil, so I'm going to turn it up to high. And then as soon as it comes to the boil, she turns it down to medium low. Here goes the taste test, people. Here it goes. That's good. Well, yeah, you know what? Yeah. And here goes this one. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Half a cup of shoyu, 2.5 to 3 tablespoons of sugar, okay?
Yes.
Bring it to a boil, reduce it to medium low, and let it cook for...
Let it cook for about 1 hour.
1 hour, and then we add in our vegetables?
Yes, and cook those for about, bring it up to another boil, put the vegetables in, turn it down, and cook it for about 15 minutes.
Okay, you're going to have to remind me. That's a whole lot of stuff to remember.
Okay.
Okay, people. You might remember. not me. We'll be back. Take the cover on or off. Ooh, medium low, people. We went to a boil. Uh-huh. So we're at medium low.
Okay, then just, yes, cover it, but, you know, leave it open a little
okay.
bit.
Okay. Just like we did with the stew, folks.
Yes.
All right, we'll see you back in an hour, guys. Okay, I'm down to 30 minutes, and it was doing nothing, so Granny says to turn it up to medium. All right, kids, so the hour is done, and in the big pot, we are adding our squash. And you just add in however much you need. Mom usually puts it all up to boil again. And then what do we do after it boils? We turn it back down to
medium.
And then how long after that?
15 minutes.
Okay, so I'm going to turn it up. And we're going to put the, let me see. Let me put you. This is the white stem. I like this, so I'm putting a lot. And I still didn't use the two bunches. This will boil down because it's really not a lot here. So I'm going to turn that up. We're going to bring it to a boil, turn it back down, and cook it for 15 minutes. Why do we bring it up to a boil?
Because otherwise it'll take longer for the squash to cook.
Oh, but what about the white stem cabbage?
The same thing.
Oh, okay. Up to high. Up to high. We'll be back. It didn't take any time. It's boiling. So, back down to medium. Sorry, I just breathed right on you. Down to medium. And so is the white stem. Down to medium. And I'm on video chat. So when this goes off, Granny's going to just turn them off for me. And I'll come later after my chat and show you the results. Bye. Okay, so that is the end of the story for the pork and squash. And let me pull out the ginger, and I'll dig out the garlic at some point just so that no one dishes it up. And you could skim, you know, before we added everything, you could skim that junk off the top there. And this is the pork with white stem cabbage. And both are just, to me, delicious once again because it's comfort food. And I hope you guys try it and I hope you enjoy.